Hey folks, this is Best in Slot, and welcome back to the Stomping Lands. Only 8 years since my last video. Not a sentence I ever expected to say ever again, but the Stomping Land is, inverted commas, back. Right, we're going to talk all about that in just a little bit. We're going to talk about the history of the game, and maybe some reasons to hold off and be a little bit pessimistic, and maybe some reasons for optimism. The history of this game is fascinating and full of drama. It was really the first big drama the dinosaur gaming community ever had, and I'm going to fill you in on that today as we chop up some dinosaurs and stuff like that. So for those who don't know, the Stomping Land is an open world. It's an open world, but it's not a huge open world. Dinosaur survival, where you play as this tribal man, hello tribal man, and you explore the island and you hunt dinosaurs and you get eaten by dinosaurs and you make traps and you craft things and you just try to survive. You know, think of Ark, think of The Forest, all these kind of games, but this was before all of them. This was like 10 years ago nearly when this first started being a thing. My last video on the Stomping Land was actually back in 2014. That's the last time the game updated, so 8 years since last update. So this is really the little seed that then birthed all these other genres eventually. You know, the isle and stuff like that sort of came from this Beasts of Prey, yada yada. I'm not saying they took from the Stomping Land, but it really was the first of its kind. And it's worth mentioning that for a lot of us, slightly older gamers, the Stomping Land was really, really exciting. This was the first big new dinosaur game in a long time. It had a lot of promise, it had a lot of potential. You know, we didn't get many dinosaur games back then at all. It was a very, very dead genre. So having a game like this was super, super exciting. It was a really big deal. They had a very successful Kickstarter campaign where they raised over $100,000, which again, back then was more money than, a lot more money comparatively than it is right now on Kickstarter. And for a while, the game had a lot of promise. People were excited, myself included. I used to do a weekly vlog series on this game called The Stomping Vlog, where I would just roam around, play the game, and talk about life and do a general vlog sort of thing, because I was, like, really into the game. I don't know why you're dead. There we go. Wait, where's my menu? There it is. I don't know why it's like that. So you got some you can do some paint. You can't do that yet, though. We can, you know, we can build some things, blah, 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 blah. I'm not too worried about the actual gameplay per se, but the point is, it was doing okay. It had a few updates. There was one called the Puertosaurus update that added a Puertosaurus to the game, although it's pretty rare. This giant sauropod looks fantastic. And then in mid-2014, it went silent. Now, the updates had already been rare up till that point. The game was definitely not updating all the time. It definitely wasn't actively updating as much as people would like. But the point is, it went super quiet. And we never heard anything ever again from about mid-2014. Now, the lead developer for this game, and really the sole developer for this game in a lot of ways, was someone called Jig. Jig was a online persona. I believe their last name is Fundora. There's dead Styracosauruses everywhere. I want to try to find a Puertosaurus. That's what we're going to do. We're going to wander around till we find one. The lead developer was Jig, and basically Jig went silent. Mid-2014, Jig took the money, and this is a statement of fact, it just is. We'll get onto all this in a minute, but Jig basically took the money, we're talking hundreds of thousands of pounds, and disappeared. Now, there were two other people working on the Stomping Land with Jig. I'm about to die. At the same time, there was a community manager who stuck around for a few months, and there was a modeler, the person who made the dinosaur models, which was, I've got the name, I've kind of forgotten it now. Vlad Konstantinov? Vlad, anyway. He's an immensely talented 3D modeler who did all the beautiful dinosaur models. And those two stuck around for a while, and from what we heard from both of those people, the community manager stuck around for a few months, and then after he wasn't hearing a thing from Jig, he basically said, you know what, I'm just stringing the community along here, saying, oh, updates are on the way, updates are on the way, and then nothing was ever happening, so he quit because nothing was coming, and he just felt like he was lying to the community. And then the modeler posted, Konstantinov posted, I think it was 2015, I think it was a whole year later nearly, saying that he has to stop working on the game because he isn't getting paid, and Jig has not responded to all his messages over the last 5 months or whatever, and has essentially disappeared off the face of the earth. So both of those people left because Jig was no longer communicating with them. And that makes sense, it's hard to work for someone who doesn't talk to you. So at that point the game was very, very much dead. There was nobody actively working on it that we could see. The reason we got initially for the delay from Jig was that the game was being delayed because it was being ported. It was initially Unreal Engine 3, I believe, and it's being ported up to Unreal Engine 4, and that was taking a lot of time. And that was the last thing we heard. And people kept asking for updates and updates and updates, and nothing ever came. And eventually the game was taken off Steam. It was just taken off entirely. The game is, it came back briefly and that was off Steam again. You can't actually buy this game right now. That will be important later on, so keep that in mind. But the point is, for those last 8 years, we haven't really heard anything. There's been rumblings here and there about maybe it's going to be coming back, maybe development's going to start up again, but nothing really happened. Until this last week. And we're going to show you something else now. Because what changed was, Jig announced that he is resuming development of the Stomping Land. He's rebuilding the game from the ground up into a whole new version, with a whole new cartoony art style, as you can see, and basically just restarting from the get-go and hoping to make the game into the game he always wanted it to be. And he said, you know, I'm going to show you the post in a little bit, but basically that's the idea, and this is the dev test. So if you own the game, and again, you cannot buy the game at this point in time, it's literally impossible. Maybe you could find a Steam key somewhere else on the internet, but from Steam itself, the game is not listed. If you own it, you can install it, and when you go to launch the game, you'll see the regular Stomping Land, and you'll also see the dev test. And this is the branch that's getting updated and turned into this new version of the game. And it's pretty basic. You can roam around this island, you can crouch, you can chuck magical glowing balls, and that is about it. This is all it is so far. So there's really not much to write home about for the current iteration, but that's not really why we're here. It's interesting alone that this is happening. I actually quite like the new art style for what it's worth. I think the character model actually looks really good. It's not what people really signed for 8 years ago, but at the end of the day, it was 8 years ago, so I'm sure people will get over it. So this is inherently an interesting thing anyway. This is this game that was full of drama. You've got to bear in mind, drama in the dinosaur gaming community was not a thing a decade ago. Now we've had our fair share, it must be said, especially with the rise of Kickstarter and all that's gone along with that. People stealing from people and all this kind of stuff going on. But back then it wasn't a thing. We didn't have any drama at all. And this was a big deal. This game disappearing with everyone's money. Kind of like loads of people wrote articles about it because it was shown as and showcased as this example of how Kickstarter doesn't work, and you know, the risks of Kickstarter and all that. You know, major media gaming outlets took it and ran with it. There were big name YouTubers with millions of subscribers covering the game. It wasn't just me and my little dinosaur channel. It was big people at the time. So it's kind of a weird blast from the past. It's worth mentioning, by the way, you will have seen Konstantinov's work when he moved on from this. What are we playing right now? Stomping Land. He worked on Beasts of Prey and sold some models to them. Beasts of Prey was kind of like Ark, like a toned down version of Ark, more elaborate than this was. It was okay. I've got some episodes on the channel if you want to blast from the past and go check it out, but it wasn't anything particularly special by the end. I heard rumblings of that coming back as well. It's all about the rumblings these days. And also The Isle, interestingly enough. And The Isle was very much in its birth point at that point as well. If you want to see some really fun stuff for The Isle, I kind of miss The Isle in a way, because I mean, you know, I covered the game since its inception, since it used to be this little weird beta test thing where you just spin this dinosaur around a billion times and stuff like that. Anyway, Konstantinov gave some or sold some models to The Isle as well. I don't know if he actively worked on the game further than that, but he at the time was sending over some models. So at least his work went somewhere when Jig disappeared. And really, that's going to be the end of the. That's going to be the next focus on this video and the ending focus of this video. Jig coming back with this dev test, with this version of the Stomping Land, has done like a big forum post on the Steam forums, kind of going into why he disappeared, what went wrong in the first place, and in his take, shedding light on some of the lies, inverted commas, well, I'm not really quoting there, but suggesting that people like Konstantinov were misleading people. He didn't understand why they were saying what they said. So before I comment too much about the future of the Stomping Land and where I think this is going to go and what I would suggest you folks at home, we'll go read that forum post because I think it's important. So this is it, the Stomping Land Rebuild Q&A. It's also worth noting, if you want another take on this whole situation and a very dramatic, very, very beautifully well-produced video with much too loud music, it's worth mentioning. I'm just going to point that out, Velossi. Tone the music down. But beyond that, a fantastically well-produced video. Velossi, who is a really, really good dinosaur YouTuber, does a lot of Path of Titan stuff in particular, has done done a bunch of good videos on Stomping Land, actually. I'll link that channel down below if you want to go check it out for yourself. But this is a fairly new thing, actually, 13th of May. This was only a few days ago, 3 days ago, this Stomping Land Q&A was published, and it's got a lot of interesting stuff in it. So he wants to talk about why the delay of 7 years, blah, 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 it's 8 years, but why the delay of 7 years and all this kind of jazz. He's rebuilding the game. I'm not going to read the whole thing out, there's a lot of it, but we're going to talk about the what I would say important bits, and really this is the main one. Jig, what happened? The primary issue with the original Stomping Land was that it didn't keep fans informed. Gonna take a big issue with that, we'll get to that in a second. There were times when the game went weeks or occasionally months without an update, fans started believing the game was abandoned, and many others got upset that prototype features weren't seen in the actual alpha release. One major mistake was that I didn't clarify the purpose of the prototype, that would be the game I showed you at the very start, which was to showcase that I'm capable of developing the features of this game. The prototype itself, however, was developed with an emphasis on speed, not structure. This means that much of the actual game had to be rebuilt so that everything was part of a unified system, working online and capable of overlapping with all other features, yada yada yada. During this transition, many features had to sit on the back burner, and he's just going on about how the updates took too long and he's very sorry for not addressing that. So my main issue with this is this. The primary issue with the original Stomping Land was that I didn't keep fans informed. And to an extent, that is true. He would disappear for a couple of months at a time, or a month at a time, give us no development updates, and it's just not a good way to develop a game. But this is a lie. Like, I'm gonna try to keep a somewhat central take on this. Well, not really, but I'm gonna try to see things from Jig's side. I really am. And we'll get to that in just a moment. But this is just flat out wrong. You know, the primary issue was that I didn't keep fans informed. No. The primary issue is that you took everyone's money and disappeared for 8 years. That's not informing people. Not informing people is a month or two. It's not nearly a decade. You know, that doesn't track at all. And this is going to be my problem with this post largely. He says, you know, where is it? Yeah, we'll read this last bit. Despite all this, most fans who were in the dark, this process interpreted these results as some kind of deception where so much was missing and updates took so long. Again, you disappeared for 8 months. 8 years, I should say. The problem was not the 1 month delay or the 2 month gap between updates. That was never the issue. Yeah, we weren't happy at the time, but the issue really is the full on disappearance at the end. And it was my fault for not addressing the obvious. For that, I'm sorry. Note he doesn't. This is the thing. Took many years. He's now confident he can develop it. Blah, 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 blah. One man dev team. Blah, blah, blah. Nothing interesting. No, at no point in this entire thing will he address the fact that he took everyone's money and vanished for nearly a decade. That does not come up. That is not addressed at any point. The primary large number one issue is entirely ignored by this post. There's no acceptance of fault there. There's no, you know, I'm sorry I took your money. I'm sorry I ran off with the money. I'm sorry I didn't talk to you for 8 years. I'm sorry that I deceived you all actively. Because he thinks, look. Despite all this, most fans were in the dark for this process, interpreted these results as some kind of deception. Like, he's putting the blame on the fans. Literally saying, oh, because I didn't keep you guys because I didn't update you guys enough, everyone thought I was stealing their money. Okay, sure, that could be a thing if you'd kept updating the game, but you didn't. You disappeared and took everyone's money. There's no deception there or not. We didn't misinterpret. You deceived everyone. I don't know how you can possibly claim otherwise. And this is a big mark against him, in my opinion, and you'll see why in a minute. He's been practicing with UE4 and doing jobs, blah blah blah. Is this some kind of cash grab? So this is important to mention. Is this some kind of cash grab? Stomping Land is not being sold or resold to anyone. As I say, the game does not currently it's not currently purchasable on Steam. I'm not accepting donations or any crowdfunding. I'm not making Stomping Land 2, nor am I making some other game. I'm rebuilding Stomping Land for free for a few reasons. I owe it to a lot of fans to give them a cool game they anticipate having. Very true. I still want to play the game the way I imagine it, despite the catalogue of similar games, which is true, but there's not actually that many games like Stomping Land out there, or at least the idea it had. I mean, Ark, sure, but Ark is balls to the walls crazy, and the Isle obviously doesn't have much of a focus on humans, even though it is now going in that direction. This kind of tribal human-only thing with the dinosaurs is at least a little bit niche. The misunderstanding of this game's history still hangs on me, and I need to fix it. Again, developing the game does not change what happened in the past. You could develop Stomping Land now and make it into the best game ever made. You could pull a full-on No Man's Sky. The misunderstanding isn't a misunderstanding. You did disappear with the money. I don't understand why he won't address that. It's really annoying. Ah! Okay, so then he goes on about about the employees you didn't pay. So this is what Konstantinov said. He said he wasn't getting paid, he had to stop work, blah, 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 blah. You know, Jig disappeared. As far as the claim from the dinosaur modeler, I don't know why he would say that. I wonder if he had anything to gain by doing so. I'm not going to entertain the topic any further because I have no intention of creating heat. And if those claims were to leverage through the proper channels, I have everything I need to dissolve it. He's basically saying if Konstantinov were ever to try and get money from Jig for unpaid models and stuff like that, Jig is claiming he has the proof necessary to shut that down and to prove himself that he didn't do anything wrong, basically. But the problem here is we don't see that. You know, this was a big mark against him as well. We do not see this evidence. Just saying, I don't want to create heat is kind of doesn't really ring true with me because the heat is already here. The heat is on you already. You need to put out a gigantic flame at this point in time. Remaining solo, blah, 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 blah. And then the last one. Okay, so before we talk about that, I want to try to see things a little bit from the other side. I don't lean on the other side, but we need to play devil's advocate, right? Jig is not selling this game. Stomping Land is not for sale. If you own it, you get access to the rebuild for free. If you don't own it, you're never going to play it anyway, right? Until one day, maybe, it's completely completed and he releases it once again as a game on Steam, which would be a nice little redemption tale. So right now, he isn't taking any money, which means I can temper my heat a little bit, because at the end of the day, he's not taking anything from anyone, so that's fine. I have two... Well, no, let me carry on first. And the other part of this was 8 years ago. He was young. He was I don't know how young he was, so I'm assuming a teenager, really, or young 20s, or whatever. He's just younger, 8 years younger. And even if he wasn't, even if he was 50 years old, people mess up, right? People make mistakes. It's just a fact of life. We all screw up. I've screwed up. You know, there's several accounts on this channel and on other channels where I've said stupid things and I've apologized for them. We've all kind of moved on over the years and other channels have had to do the same. It's just the way it is. We're human. People mess up. You have to show, however, that you've improved, that you acknowledge your problems, that you acknowledge what you did wrong, and then try to make amends. You can't just ignore it for 8 years and then go, oh, well, I'm better now. Here's my new thing. And I guess that is one of my big problems with this. And I'm all for giving people the second chance. You know, at the end of the day, it was a long time ago. Wounds heal. We all got over it, right? But if Jig wants people to give him a second chance, he needs to kind of own up to what actually happened. This feels like a very soft... This feels like those YouTuber apologies where they say, oh, I'm sorry you felt that way, or that I was misinterpreted and all that kind of nonsense. There's no actual admission of proper guilt here. And there should be. He took hundreds of thousands of pounds and disappeared off the face of the earth. There's no wiggle room there. No matter how he tries to spin it, that is literally what happened. And the big gap is not at all addressed, as I've said. He says, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't communicate enough in these little gaps. But then where did you go for 8 years? What happened to the money? None of this is mentioned at all. So until that is done, he can't, in my opinion, be redeemed completely. Because you can't ask for redemption and you can't have your misunderstood scenario, misunderstood game rehabilitated if you don't face up to what actually happened, as far as I'm concerned. The other problem with the whole thing, the idea that Jig changed, he's going to develop this game and it's free and blah, blah, blah. First of all, just because it's free doesn't mean it's free. Sort of. We see it a lot in football with sports washing. The idea that, you know, some country, in this case with Newcastle, for example, it's Saudi Arabia, they buy Newcastle Football Club and they're doing what's called sports washing in that they're going to build Newcastle up to be this great club, not really get any money from it themselves, but what they do is they improve their visual. They improve how they seem to the rest of the world. And we've seen it happening already. Anyways. And there's another kink in that. So, what's the deal with all the bans? And Velocity has a great section on this, but it was before this post. I really don't want to ban anyone, but some people just turn vitriol into a hobby. And ultimately, the forums aren't for me, they're for everyone else. And if someone is spitting misinformation, and that is the key point, or starting arguments, and I have no problem giving the boot, just be friendly, right? Several people have been banned from the community forums for the Stomping Land. They've had their posts removed, and they've been banned. The posts were fine. The posts were totally chill. It was just, you know what, if you want to be redeemed, if you want people to play this game again, if you want people to trust you again, you have to own up to what actually happened. You have to explain where the money went. It's all the stuff I've been saying. You have to explain where the money is. You have to explain what happened for 8 years, blah, 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 blah. And he's just banning them. He's just full on banning them from the forums. The idea that they're spitting misinformation when you have not addressed... You can't claim people are spitting misinformation and then not address what actually happened. If you didn't steal the money, well, take the money and disappear for 8 years, Explain it then! You can't go, no, that's not what happened, you're banned. Well, what did happen then? I'm not telling you! and the thing is, as I just said about the sports washing, it's all well and good, it's free, but you look at the comments and you look at the forums and the number of people who are excited about this and say, good luck, Jig, and we're rooting for you and I can't wait to play the game again. It works. It really works. And it works so quickly. And anyone who dared speak up against it is getting shut down in no time at all. Good luck, Jig. I don't want to... there's a lot of good luck. There's a lot of I believe in you, all this kind of jazz. He stole your money! Why is everyone trusting him? It's nonsense. Anyways, that is the drama of the Stomping Land. It really annoys me. And I've been guilty of it in the past. This is another thing that I did wrong in the past that I now own up to and I'm trying to be much more conscientious of. Mesozoica, for example. I donated a lot of money to Mesozoica, guys. I was like the top tier donator, like several hundred dollars at least. And they took everyone's money, pumped out one of the worst games in human history and then disappeared off the face of the earth. And I was like, no, I will defend this. Don't criticize the game too much. Blah, blah, blah. I'm like, no, that's nonsense. Criticize them, they stole your money. Consumer forward, right? Now, as I say, the benefit is Jake's not trying to take anyone's money quite yet. So we can go easy on it for a little bit. We can see what happens. Maybe he'll end up developing this incredible game and then when he finally asks money for it, that will be okay. The jury is very much still out. I will be keeping a close eye on this. I'm very curious as to where it goes. I would love to see this go really well, but I think for the Stomping Land to ever get away from the past, Jake has to own up to what actually happened. And at the moment, I just don't see that happening. He needs to just man up a little bit, you know? As much as I hate that phrase deeply, I'm very sorry for using it already, but it's what it is. Right. That's it from me. So this is the drama of the Stomping Land. It's really interesting, at the very least. I've not had a drama in a little while, so I'm quite excited to talk about it. I would like to believe people can get better and people can do better things. And I would like to believe that someday I'll be sitting here on this channel going, welcome back to the Stomping Vlog or something like that. That would be awesome. But other things need to happen before that. And we'll see if they do. And as soon as money starts exchanging hands, especially if the product is not good at that point in time, I'll be harsher. I've been quite light today, actually, in some ways. So we'll see how it goes. But my goal with this video now is more to hopefully protect, to inform, to entertain, but to also protect a little bit. I've not been great at that in the distant past. And now I think it's important to be fully honest and truthful. And it's your money and it's your time and you deserve what I would consider the truth. No truth is absolute. At the end of the day, this is my version of the truth, but this is, I think, the right way to interpret what's going on. I don't know, maybe people will disagree. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. That's about it. Thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Inform me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Definitely go check out Velocity's very dramatic, very well-produced videos. And I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Cheers, much love, and as always, bye-bye.